Hello friend, in this video lecture, we will discuss the application of Fourier cosine transform. This is the third lecture on application of Fourier transform. In first two lecture, we have discussed about the application of Fourier transform and Fourier sine transform. Both transform operate on the heat equation. Similarly here, the Fourier cosine transform is operate on the heat equation and we find the solution of heat equation. What is the heat equation? See, the first order derivative of u with respect to t is equal to c square. Second order derivative of u with respect to x. That is, u is a function of x and t. So first of all, we write the formula, Fourier cosine formula for u. Okay. See, the Fourier cosine transform of u, where u is a function of x and t, is equal to capital U suffix C, which is function of x and k and t is equal to under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity small u into cos of kx with respect to x integration. Okay, and its inverse transform of cosine, inverse Fourier cosine transform, is written as a u is equal to, where u is a function of x and t, is equal to under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity capital U. See, put capital U here, suffix C, which is function of k and t, cos of kx with respect to k integration. Okay, see here. Let me clear you. In some author write here simply one. If you not taken here under root 2 upon pi, that time you have to take here simply 2 upon pi. Okay. In most of the book, instead of k, lambda is taken. See here, x is mapped to the k. Okay. In most of the book, instead of k, lambda is taken. So note down this difference. Also, the Fourier transform of the U, Fourier transform of U is, instead of capital U, most of the book, it is taken by the U bar. U bar is a Fourier cosine transform of U, U bar suffix C in this. Okay, so remember, K instead of K, lambda is there, and instead of capital U, there is a small U bar is there. Okay. So first write here, when we use Fourier cosine transform, what is the condition for applying the, what is the boundary and condition for applying the Fourier cosine transform? See, if boundary condition U and dava u by dava x tends to zero as x tends to infinity, and the second condition is very important, and dava u by dava x is equal to zero, or function of t when at x is equal to zero, and for all t. So if the condition dava u by dava x is given, it may be a zero or some function of t. That time we use a Fourier cosine transform. Okay. See, in previous lecture, simply u is there. U is equal to zero, or f of t at x is equal to zero. That time we use a Fourier sine transform. Okay. Now let us define the formula for partial derivative. Actually, there is a theorem. I'm going to put direct formula here. That is a Fourier cosine transform of partial derivative of u with respect to t is ordinary derivative. That is, derivative of capital U suffix C with respect to t. Okay. And the second one is Fourier cosine transform of second order derivative of u with respect to x is minus k square capital U suffix c, capital U is a function of k and t, minus simply dy by u by dy by x at x is equal to 0. Okay, so second formula for second order partial derivative. So using these two formulas, we find the solution of heat equation. Now let us take the example of Fourier cosine transform. Use Fourier transform to solve dy by u by dy by t is equal to second order derivative of u with respect to x. Okay, the x is lies between 0 and infinity and t is positive, subject to the condition. The first is dy by u by dy by x at x is equal to 0, which is 0. Okay, t is greater than 0. The second condition is initial condition u of x comma 0 is equal to x when x is lies between 0 and 1, and 0 x is strictly greater than 1. And third condition is boundedness, mod of u x comma t is less than capital M. M is some positive number. Okay, now solution. So we start the solution from this equation, say equation number 1. Okay, now u of x t will be the solution of equation 1. Now since x is given, which is lies between 0 and infinity, okay, and the second one is very important, and dy by u by dy by x at x is equal to 0 is given, the condition is given, c. That's why we use Fourier cosine transform. So first of all, we write the formula for Fourier cosine transform. Capital F suffix c is operate on small u, its image is capital U suffix c is equal to under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity u of x comma t cos of kx with respect to x integration, see equation number 2. Now apply the Fourier transform on equation 1, taking Fourier cosine transform of equation 1. So here we apply the Fourier transform. What we get? That is Fourier cosine of dy by u by dy by t is equal to Fourier cosine of second order derivative of u with respect to x. Sometimes c square is multiplied. That time write c square outside, since c square is constant. So we have seen the formula of dy by u by dy by t for Fourier cosine is ordinary derivative of u suffix c with respect to t is equal to second order formula is minus k square capital U suffix c k comma t minus dy by u by dy by x at x is equal to 0. Okay, now since dy by u by dy by x is given at x is equal to 0, see the condition number 1. Condition number 1, the value of the partial derivative with respect to x at x equal to 0 is 0. Okay, so what is the remaining term here? The remaining term is simply first order derivative first order derivative suffix c. Now use variable separable method, capital du by divided by u, separate the variable, separate u and separate t. Now on integration, when we apply integration, see the left hand side. In left hand side, there is a f dash upon f. The derivative of denominator is present in numerator, that is log of function. So here instead of log, we write ln. Ln means natural log. Otherwise, you write the log function. No problem. Okay. That is ln. Sorry, ln f. So f means ln capital U suffix c is equal to minus k square t. The integration of dt is t plus integration constant. See here, log function is exist. So that's why we write the constant function as a logarithmic function. That is logarithmic constant. So here we convert this equation throughout in terms of log. The first term in right hand side, we can write, see here, the log of e raised to function is function. We have the function. We can write the function in terms of log in this way. That is ln capital U, ln e raised to minus k square t plus ln A. Apply ln A plus ln B. Log of A plus log of B is log of A into B. So taking anti-log both sides, then we get capital U suffix C. It can be written as capital U suffix C, which is function of K and T, is equal to what is remaining here? A e raised to minus K square T. Say equation number 3. Now next task is find the integration constant. To find integration constant, for that put t is equal to 0 in equation number 2 and equation number 3. See the equation 2 and 3, the left hand side is same, that is capital U and capital U. The first we simplify the equation number 2, where we put t is equal to 0. Capital U suffix c k comma 0 is equal to under root 2 upon pi, 0 to infinity. See here, equation 2, here we put t is equal to 0. That is u of x comma 0 cos of kx with respect to x. Now since u of x 0 is given, which is x when x is lies between 0 and 1, and 0 when x is greater than 1. So see here, we have the interval 0 to infinity of integration. Now we divide as a 0 to 1 and 1 to infinity. 0 to 1, the value of u of x 0 is 1. And 1 to infinity, the value of u is 0. So it can be written as under root 2 upon pi, 0 to 1, its value is 1 cos, sorry, not 1, see here, which is x. Here x cos of kx with respect to x, and plus second 1 to infinity, that time value is 0 cos of kx dx. The second one is 0. The only remaining first term, 0 to 1 x cos of kx dx. So here we apply the bypass rule. Keep under root 2 upon pi as it is. X as it is, integration of cosine is sine of kx divided by k, minus derivative of x is 1, and the integration of sine function is minus cos of kx, and the derivative of kx is k and previous k, that is k square. Okay, integration 0 to 1. See here, the plus 1 means derivative plus 1 and derivative of the 1 is 0. We use generalized bypass rule here. U as it is v1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 minus, in this way. Here we select u as a x and v as a cos of kx. We apply the generalized bypass rule here. Put upper limit here, upper limit and lower limit. Put x is equal to throughout 1, that is sine of k divided by k, and this minus and this minus, minus minus plus, okay, plus cos of k divided by k square, upper limit. Lower limit, x is 0, the first term is 0 here, this is minus lower limit, and here minus minus plus, but see here, lower limit, that is minus, and this two minus sign and this one, that is odd time minus sign, then keep minus sign as it is and put x is equal to 0, cos 0 is 1, 1 upon k square. Okay, so see here, the LCM is k square, so it can be written as under root 2 pi, multiply and divide k here, that is k into sine of k plus cos of k minus 1 divided by k square. So we got capital U suffix C k comma 0 is equal to under root 2 upon pi k into sine of k plus cos of k minus 1 divided by k square. Say equation number, see the previous is 3, say equation number 4. Now next, we put t is equal to 0 in a 2 and 3. We simplify 2. Now simplify the 3. Put t is equal to 0 in 3. E raised to 0 is 1. What is remaining? Only a. That is u of, this is equation 3 is implies. So what we get? A is remaining. Say equation number 5. Now from 4 and 5, left hand side is same, that's why right hand side is same. So we get A is equal to 2 upon pi k into sine k plus cos of k minus 1 divided by k square. Okay, so put this value, put in equation 3, put in equation 3, see the equation 3, that is capital U suffix C k comma t is equal to under root 2 upon pi k into sine of k plus cos of k minus 1 divided by k square into e raised to, see here, e raised to minus k square t, minus k square into t. Okay, see, small u is a solution of the given one dimensional heat equation, and we apply the Fourier cosine transform and we got the capital U. So how we get the, our claim is find the small u, and we got the capital U. So how we get the small u? For that, call its inverse cosine transform by Fourier cosine inverse transform. Inverse transform of cosine, that is small u of x comma t is equal to under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity capital U suffix C cos of kx with respect to k integration. Now substitute this value here, that is under root 2 upon pi 0 to infinity, here again under root 2 upon pi in bracket k times sine of k plus cos of k minus 1 divided by k square minus 1 e to the power minus k square t cos of kx with respect to k integration. Now here under root 2 pi, and this under root 2 pi becomes simply 2 upon pi 0 to infinity. The remaining term is k into sine k plus cos of k minus 1 divided by k square e raised to minus k square t cos of kx with respect to k integration. So this is small u, okay, which is required solution of one dimensional equation. Okay, thank you.